Andrew, I'll start with you if I can. The biggest recommendation, this idea that we split the board of the RBA into a monetary policy board, which has got all these expert macroeconomists, labour market experts, etc. They'll make the call over the cash rate. And then there will be a separate governance board that looks after all the other things that the RBA does that I think most people probably aren't aware of. This is similar to some models overseas. What do you think about it?
Oh, well, good evening, Peta. In general, let me begin by saying I can understand why the government would be dissatisfied with the performance of the Reserve Bank, and I think the performance of the Reserve Bank has been very unsatisfactory for a number of years now. That said, I'm not convinced that this is the right way to go. For a number of reasons. First of all, it's always a little bit worrying when politicians decide to start creating new boards to determine monetary policy. The risk is that we'll get a board that's stacked with political appointees designed to try to make the, you know, smooth the way for the government. But leaving that aside, let's suppose that that does not occur, that, you know, some mechanism is found to prevent that occurring in the process, in the legislative process. I'm still not convinced that the idea of having a board supposedly with more expertise in relation to monetary policy determining interest rates is a good idea. And in particular, this idea that we should follow the model of, say, the Bank of Canada or the Bank of England or the Federal Reserve in having more people who are specifically monetary policy experts on the board rather than people with business expertise and awareness of conditions around the economy. And the reason I say that is just that we in Australia are entitled to be unhappy about the performance of the Reserve Bank in recent years, but actually, if you look at the period since the global financial crisis, the Reserve Bank has actually performed better than most other Western central banks. In fact, the performance of the Federal Reserve, the Bank of England, the Bank of Canada has been much worse than the performance of the Reserve Bank. In fact, for much of that period when we had Governor Stevens as governor, we did a lot better. So this idea that you do better by having a lot of people with more academic expertise or that you need to follow what other central banks are doing is a poor one. Really, the problem in recent years has not been a lack of expertise in performing analysis. It's been a lack of courage, I think. It's been a concern about taking a stance that's different from what's been done overseas. And Glenn Stevens was very much prepared to do that in the wake of the global financial crisis, but Phil Lowe wasn't prepared to do it in recent years, and that's led to some very poor outcomes.